most people understand that watersheds affect the reefs. This is a major paradigm in conservation biology. And the ancient Hawaiians knew this too, that there was a Mauka-Makai connection, a connection between the mountains and the sea. They had an ahupua'a system of resource management and land division. And they had 580 watersheds throughout the state where people lived, grew their food, and they realized that what they did on land was going to affect their fishing practices. So this was very important to them. They knew this years ago. But we really had no quantitative evidence on a large scale to show that this is really true, that the watersheds are connected to the reefs. So what we did was we had a lot of data from our monitoring program, and we used this data to develop an index to look at reef health. In the meantime, one of our colleagues at the university, Mike Kito, was looking at the watershed health. He looked at streams and native plants and a variety of other factors in the watershed that would point to having a healthy watershed. And he ranked those from 0 to 100. We use this ranking to compare the watershed health and the reef health. And what we found was, on a statewide basis, there is a connection between the watersheds and the reef. The healthier the watersheds, the healthier the reefs. But we did find something else very interesting. Not all watersheds are equal. If you go around the islands to the east and the west, that strong relationship between watersheds and reefs diminish. And by the time you get to north-facing shores, there is almost no connection between the watersheds and the reefs. The main connection, the strongest link, is between watersheds on south-facing shores in shallower waters. Now, this makes sense if you think about it, because watersheds in north-facing environments have higher wave energy. And this can take out a lot of the land-derived materials and take it further offshore, away from the reefs. Also, south shores were developed earlier because they have the calmer waters and the nicer beaches. And so harbors were made there, and the population started there. So you have history of insult to watersheds on the south shore on most of the islands. We found that the population is important to watersheds. Overall, the larger the population in the watershed, the poorer the reef is doing.